Now we're going to talk about addition, and we're going to get to where the addition of integers. Our section here is working with integers mostly. But we're going to review some of the sets of numbers that we know. We start with the counting numbers, 1, 2, 3, and so on. That's how we count. We don't start with 0, we start with 1, right? That's why they're called the counting numbers. They're also called the natural numbers, so you may see that in other math classes. They're also the counting numbers, natural numbers, those are the same thing. Whole numbers, well, now we have 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. The integers, that's a little bit harder to list. We have all the whole numbers, 0, 1, 2, 3, and on, and their opposites. So you have to go in the other way, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, and on down that way, smaller and smaller. So that's a listing of the integers, a listing of the counting numbers, and a listing of the whole numbers. Notice that all counting numbers are also whole numbers, and they're also integers. All whole numbers are also integers. Okay, so now we're going to get to the addition part. We're going to use what's called the CHIP method. And it's a good method. You may have think about it other ways. You may think about it in terms of money or something else that you've learned in the past, and that's fine. But I'll show you what we call the CHIP method. So what we do is we represent the numbers with chips. Blue will represent a positive. So that's going to be a positive chip. A little thick. And then red is going to represent a negative chip. So here we go. So we'll start here at the beginning. So we have five positive chips. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we're going to add 3 more. 1, 2, 3. And then we can count up all the positives, and we get 8, right? A positive 8. We knew that. 5 plus 3 was 8. We knew that. But I'm just kind of showing you how the CHIP method works. So now let's say you have negative chips. So you have negative 5 chips, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you have negative 3 chips, 1, 2, 3. Well, then all together, what have you got? Negative 8, right? So if you have a negative 5 and a negative 3, you're not going to get a positive out of that. It's going to be a negative 8. So it's kind of like if you were already $5 in the hole in your checkbook and you took out 3 more dollars, now you're $8 in the hole in your checkbook. You have a negative 8 balance. That's how I think of it sometimes with money. I guess I'm used to negative numbers with money. Okay, so now let's say we have negative 5. Go back to my, I need negative 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But I'm going to have a positive 3. 1, 2, 3. Well, one negative and one positive cancel each other out. So that's going to be 0. Let's switch to these. That's going to be 0. That's going to be 0. What do I have left? Negative 2. If you think of it in terms of money, you had, you know, a balance of negative 5, but then you deposited $3. So now your balance is negative 2. That might make some sense. Okay. Now our last one, we've got negative, or we have positive 5, yay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, I'm thinking in terms of money. And we're going to add a negative 3 chips. Okay, so all of these are out because they add up to 0. And so what do we have? We have a positive 2. So it's like you had $5 in the checkbook, and then you withdrew $3, and now you have $2. You still have $2, so that's good. Okay. Now let's go to our example. So I'm not going to probably draw all the chips, but we'll just talk about it here. I have negative 2 and a negative 4. So picture, you know, 2 red chips and 4 red chips. It's going to be negative 6. Okay. And you can go back to the examples up above. It relates to this example here, so if that helps. Okay. Now, I have negative 2 chips, so 2 red chips, but I'm bringing in 4 blue chips. So I've got more blue chips, so I'm going to have a positive, and it's going to be 2. You can do this with a number line also. Sometimes people like that. Here you are at negative 2, And then you're adding 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4 is 0. And that gets you to 2. Okay, that's another way. I always think of it as money. So I was $2 in the hole, and I deposited 4. So yay, I got more positive. I've got $2. Okay. And then our last example, or you can think of the chip method. So I've got 2 blue chips, but I'm bringing in 4 negative, 4 red chips. So I've got more negative than I do positive. The answer is going to be negative 2. You can use the number line. You can use the chips. You can think about money. In your bank account, you had $2, but you wrote a check for 4. So now you're in the hole, $2. Okay. That is addition.